friends, so here in this problem we have to show that f of z, which is hyperbolic cos z, is analytic, and we have to find its derivative. Now guys, how to show that given function f of z is analytic? So it's so simple that we just have to prove the Cauchy Riemann equation for that given particular function f of z, and if the Cauchy Riemann equation or the conditions of Cauchy Riemann are satisfied, then we say yes, the given function is analytic. Now to prove the Cauchy Riemann equations, we have two options. One is using the polar coordinates or by using the Cartesian coordinates. So here we have a function as hyperbolic cos z. So what we can do is, where z is a complex number, so I can represent this z as x plus I y. So I'll convert it into Cartesian coordinates, and then the Cauchy Riemann equation in Cartesian coordinates is dou u by dou x is nothing but dou v by dou y. So we'll prove this condition, as well as we'll prove that dou u by dou y is nothing but minus dou v by dou x. So by proving these two conditions for the function f of z, we can prove that the given function is analytic. Now guys, to prove these two conditions, we should have the value of u and v with us. Now what is u and v? So u and v is nothing but function of x and y. So to get it, what we'll do is, we'll substitute z as x plus iy, and then we'll try to find out the real part and imaginary part out of this f of z. The real part will be called as u and the imaginary part will be called as v. So let's start. So here I'll say f of z is equal to hyperbolic cos z. So I can say it is nothing but hyperbolic cos of x plus iy. So I'm converting that function z in terms of x and y, so that I can separate the real and imaginary part. Now, what is the formula of hyperbolic cos x plus iy? So it is nothing but hyperbolic cos x into hyperbolic cos iy plus hyperbolic sin x into hyperbolic sin iy. So guys, you should know this formula to expand this hyperbolic cos of a plus b. So it is almost similar to trigonometric function cos a plus b, which is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. But here in hyperbolic, we have hyperbolic cos a into hyperbolic cos b plus hyperbolic sin a into hyperbolic sin b. So by using this formula, we have expanded it. Now hyperbolic cos x will remain as it is, but here at hyperbolic cos iy, we have to substitute one property, and that property is nothing but the relationship between the hyperbolic function and circular function, that is your trigonometric function. So what is that identity? So here I'll show that hyperbolic cos of I theta is given by cos of theta. So this is the relationship between hyperbolic function and circular function. So here I can say it is iy. So this would be cos of y. Next, plus sin hx as it is. Now again, for hyperbolic sin iy, we have to use the identity. Now for hyperbolic sin I theta, we say it is I sin theta. So this will become I sin of y. So we have converted these hyperbolic functions into circular function. So now if you'll observe carefully, so it is nothing but u plus iv. So therefore u is equal to hyperbolic cos x and cos y, and v is equal to hyperbolic sin x into sin y. So we got the value of u and v. Now we will prove the Cauchy Riemann equations, and to prove this Cauchy Riemann equations, we have to find out the four derivatives, that is dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y. So let's find it out. So first of all, I'll differentiate u with respect to x. So here we'll get dou u by dou x equal to, so since we are differentiating u with respect to x partially, so y will remain constant. So cos y is constant, and the derivative of hyperbolic cos x is hyperbolic sin x. So here we will get cos y as it is, and the derivative is hyperbolic sin x. Next, let's find out dou u by dou y. So I am differentiating u with respect to y partially. So u is this. So since I am differentiating with respect to y, x is constant, so hyperbolic cos x is constant, and derivative of cos y is minus sin y. So we will get hyperbolic cos x as it is and minus of sin y. Next, let's find out the value of dou v by dou x and dou v by dou y. So dou v by dou x, we have to differentiate v with respect to x partially by treating y constant. So v is this, y is constant, so sin y is constant, and derivative hyperbolic sin x is hyperbolic cos x. So hyperbolic cos x into sin y. Next, let's differentiate v with respect to y. So x is constant, so hyperbolic sin x constant, derivative of sin y is cos y. So we will get hyperbolic sin x into cos of y. Now guys, let's observe the relationship. So here, this function dou u by dou x is cos y hyperbolic sin x, and the similar function we are getting here, that is cos y hyperbolic sin x. So I can say this term and this term is same. So therefore I'll say dou u by dou x is exactly equal to dou v by dou y. And let's see the another relationship. So dou v by dou x, if you'll see, its value is hyperbolic cos x sin y, which is exactly same like this, only opposite in sign. So we'll multiply this term with negative sign, then we will get both values as same. So I can say dou v by dou x is equal to minus dou u by dou y. And guys, these two equations are nothing but Cauchy Riemann equations. So here I can say that therefore CR equations or Cauchy Riemann equations are satisfied, and whenever Cauchy Riemann equation are satisfied, we say that the given function is analytic. So here I'll say therefore f of z is analytic. Now guys, after that we have to find out its derivative. It means the derivative of f of z. So it's so simple that we can directly get the derivative of f of z. So guys, there are two ways to find out the derivative of this function. If you'll directly find it out, you'll get f dash of z as hyperbolic sin z as the answer. But what if that the function f of z is not given in terms of z? See, there are certain cases when this f of z will not be given in terms of z, whereas it will be given in terms of x and y. So that time, to get f dash of z, here I'll write it down, f of z is hyperbolic cos z, so therefore f dash of z is sin hyperbolic sin z. So sometimes I'm talking about that this function of z is given in terms of x and y, and that time to get the f dash of z, we cannot differentiate with respect to z on both sides, because on right hand side we have function in terms of x and y. So in those cases, how to get the derivative of analytic function? So for that, we will see the formula. So when we had learned the Cauchy-Riemann equation Cartesian coordinates, I told you that these are the formulas of the derivative of the analytic function f of z. So we can use any of the formula to get the derivative of f of z. And if you will observe, then these formulas are given in terms of the dou u by dou x and dou v by dou x, or dou u by dou y and dou v by dou y, which are nothing but the terms of Cauchy-Riemann equations. So by using these terms, or you can see here that dou u by dou x is nothing but differentiation of u with respect to x, and dou v by dou x is nothing but differentiation of v with respect to x. It means if the function is given in terms of x and y here, then also you can differentiate it with respect to x and y, and you can get the terms, and by using this formula you can get the answer. So what we'll do is, since we know the answer, we'll verify this answer by using any of the formula. So let's use the first formula. But also remember that if you will use any of these four formula, you will get the same answer. So let's start with the first formula. So f dash of z is nothing but dou u by dou x plus I dou v by dou x. Let's say this is the formula I am using to get the derivative. So what is value of dou u by dou x? Here we have the value. So I can say it is hyperbolic sin x cos y plus I. What is value of dou v by dou x? So it is hyperbolic cos x into sin y. So now if you will see here, then we got one term as hyperbolic, one term as circular. Similarly here, one term is hyperbolic and other one is circular. So what we will do is, so here I am doing some adjustments, and these adjustments are based on the formula which we have just seen. So we have seen this formula, cos theta is equal to hyperbolic cos of I theta. Now guys, what I am doing is, since we have one hyperbolic term and other is circular, so I will convert this circular term into hyperbolic term. So here this will become hyperbolic sin x and cos y. By using this identity, we will say it is hyperbolic cos I y. So this is hyperbolic cos of I y. Next, plus cos h x as it is, and for sin y, and we have I as an extra term, so I sin y, we will use the second identity, that is I sin theta is sin h I theta. So I sin y we have, which will become sin h I y. So here I will say it is hyperbolic sin of I y. Now guys, let's observe the angles. So with hyperbolic sin we have x, here for with hyperbolic cos we have x, so angle is same. Here we have I y with cos hyperbolic, and here with hyperbolic sin we have I y, so again angle is same. So this is nothing but the formula of hyperbolic sin of x plus I y, and x plus I y is nothing but a complex number z, so we can say it is nothing but hyperbolic sin of z. And if you will see, then we got the same answer for f dash of z. So by using this property of analytic function, you can still get the derivative of function f of z if that function is not given in terms of z. So if it is given in terms of x and y, don't get panic. You have the standard formula. Now this is not the single formula, we have four formulas to get the derivative of such analytic functions. So here we got the answer, the derivative of the given analytic function. Thank you.